All right, it's time for you to start applying the layout skills you just learned. And here's what it looks like on desktop. Not that great. I think you can do a lot better. For this part in the project, pick a set of breakpoints that you think look good, and then use one of the patterns that you just learned to style the page so it looks great even on desktop and tablet. If you didn't finish the exercise from the last time you worked on the project, don't worry. You can grab a working copy linked in the instructor notes below. Make sure that you test on phones, tablets, and browser windows of all different sizes so that you get a sense of what the page looks like everywhere. Adjust your breakpoints until you get something that you're happy with. And remember, what might work on one phone might not work so well on others. And of course, if you can, make sure that you test on real devices as well, because sometimes you'll uncover unexpected behavior or design elements that, well, you just didn't expect. I'm going to show you what we came up with, but this is by no means the right answer. This is just what we like, and you could totally go in a different direction, and if you're happy with it, then that's great. But this is what we did. We've got a breakpoint here, and then another breakpoint there. The important part of this part of the project is that you try out different layout patterns and find out what you like. Good luck.